All right, let's service 3 units for the winter, even though it is 71 degrees out here. So, it'll be fun. Servicing it for the winter time, and here it is December something, and it's 70 degrees. So which one should we grab first? Let's go on over here and grab this. I do believe this is a York. These two here. And then we'll grab the good old Goodman. So first thing we need to do is get in this box here. And it'll be this box. Two. Oh. Kill the power to this here. Label see this would be which one is this. Let's see, there's no letter on this nowhere. I'm taking the notion it's gonna be A, but we're gonna kill A, and then we open up and see if we got any voltage going to it. So let's get going and see what we got.
.5 on the contactor. Okay, the capacitor is supposed to be 30 plus 7.5. Let's see what we got. chromatic side. This would be 30. On the chromatic side, we have 31.07. So we're looking good. On the fan side, supposed to be a 7.5. We're looking 7. We're looking at 7.72. So we're good on that as well. Alright, now it's time to take the top off, or the fan, and clean out the debris that's sitting inside of the unit, prevent it from rusting no faster than it normally should. So let's get to that. Thank you.
contactor reading 19.3 contactor. Capacitor is supposed to be 30 plus 7.5, same as the one here. So I'm going to put in microfarads. Let's see if we can get at least this one read as good as the last one. Oh yeah, that's on there good. Goodness. Okay. Let's see. Check the harmonic side, and we have chromatic side 30.97. Fan side 7.67. All good on that. Right. Looking good so far. The contactors are very close to being out of range. We like to keep the contactor ohms pretty much anywhere between 10 and 20. Close to 15 is possible, but if it gets below 10 or higher than 20, it needs to be changed because the coil's getting too weak. These two are almost there because it's reading 19. And this one is calling now because it just came on, but all they're going to get is fan. But since we are got this one going, we might as well check the defrost. They put these in the tightest spots to get to them jumpers. Up nicely. Out of defrost. back in heat mode. It has a delay. Instead of just changing the reversing valve going back into heat mode, it shuts down to balance out the pressure so the compressor will not be under a heavy strain when it switches. Connections look good, solid. Ground wire good. First thing we need to do is be sure that that breaker is actually killing the power to the unit. So we're going to check across. Okay, we're good on there. Let's see what we get on the contactors. Let's see if we can get the wire off in here. What kind of ohms we have. All right. So far, everyone's 19. 18.3. Try again. 18.3. All right, now, capacitor, which we cannot tell what size it is because we can't see the number. So, I'm going to twist it a little bit. Just a little bit if we can twist it. The wires are tight. I have to loosen up the wires just a little bit to be able to get this thing to twist. Ooh. So we're going to have to take the wires off to get this thing to twist. They are tight, tight. Real tight. Really tight. Situation here. All right. This one is supposed to be, it's on there somewhere. Oh, I have to push it up to see it. All right. Supposed to be 45.5. So, let's find out what it is. Take off the fan size. Give it a little slack in the wire. Don't touch. Even though we got the power off, we can still have 24 volts in this compartment because the air handler will be sending the voltage out. So we still have to be careful where our wires go and be cautious as if it has power still on it. So we'll go to the microfarad. We'll go on the automatic side, supposed to be 45.5. Let's see if we get 45. magic number is. Let's try the fan side. So we can get the, how close we can get to 5. So we're good there as well. Good. So far so good. That's the way I like it. I like reading where they're supposed to be. Tight versus switch. All right. All right, now it's time to just take this top off. And the disadvantage of this particular unit, you can't take it off like the other one. You have to take this whole casing off. Top, not just the grill and the fan. So we got to go all around, take all the screws out to get that point. That ain't gonna work. We'd be able to do that. Which would be good old nut driver. Thank goodness for short screws. Okay, that should be on. Now let's see if we can get this thing picked up and lean against the wall. So we can get down in there and clean with the debris. Easier just to disconnect the wires. Just to get this out of these wires are just not going to be long enough. So, I have to come in here and get this out of here just to get the wires out of here. Which should be this one. This one and that. There's not enough room to actually get that top off. effectively and be out of the way to actually clean it. So we have to get this out of the way. Some of them you can lean against the wall, but since it comes from here, you can't lean it that way. So you just best just to get the wires completely out. And you know they always have a strap somewhere in here, so they just don't come out that easy. Oh yeah, they have to strap them in there too. And more strap. So you can't just take it off easy. As well, just to get the wires to come out. But with persuasion, they don't make it easy. Get the debris out of here. This one's not gonna make it easy because you got reach so far. It's a tall one. So you have to really reach in here to get this out. Being tall comes in handy, long arms, trying to clean out a unit. Check all the tubings, which I see some here that's rubbing against each other. Get that from rubbing. Don't want no leaks. Not much in this one, well, because it's all in the corner, but good location. Good now. Fun. get this back on here. I'm getting down there and getting the wires back in the hole. Have fun with that. Battle the fingers. Let's see. I have to take good old gloves off to get my hand in there. Feel the holes where it's supposed to go through. Then I can concentrate and get this strapped in there. Alright. Right behind everything. You don't need much room. Put all copper lines all in the way. Get one at a time. That's that one. And run. Now I'm just looking to get the passive side started here. Here. Oh, come on. Be nice. Cooperate. There we go. Alright, we got all three in there. Shoulder. Alright, that'll be definitely out of the way. Right. Not gonna pinch no fingers today. I'm gonna be sure we got gloves to put this bad boy on. Put in a screw just to be able to hold it in there, keep it from popping out on us. Not magnetic. There we are. There we go. Now, get the rest of them in here. That's on this side. Now I just got to get right up in here. See, it's a lot easier. We had an easier design here to get the top one off instead of the way this was made. Screw it here. Keep it going anywhere. Hold that down. With the drill. Oh, come on. There we go. Now, the rest of them. Good old nut driver. All right, the video got interrupted because I got a phone call. I do not know if you heard it ring or not. I don't know if it kills the video then rings or rings and kills the video. But that was somebody that wanted to know if I can change evaporator coil today. And they're 2 hours away from where I'm at now, and I still have not even checked the air handlers on these three units, nor have I checked the defrost on this one and the defrost on the one over there. So nope, no evaporator coil change today. So we're going to go check the air handlers, make sure all the capacitors, they have capacitors if it's not variable speed motors and whatnot. And then we'll turn on the two units that we have not checked defrost for, and check the pressure and the defrost. Make sure it goes in the defrost cycle. So let's get to the air handlers.
two of the air handlers are up there. So let's go. Yeah, let's go ahead and grab this one and see what we get. All right, let's get to this one. All right, we have variable speed. So we're not going to check no capacitor on this one. So check the amps. Let's see how many amps instead we got in this one. Marked. So let's figure out which one we have. Anywhere. Nothing marked. Okay. Now we got it. Ready. Got 5 kW in here is what it says. So let's check and see if we can get this bad boy to fire up the heat. Wires in the back behind that. It's not a good place to pinch them wires. Connection's all good. Let's check the amps and see how we're doing on this. Let's see. All right, we got the... Let's see where we're at. They're killing the... outside. Yep, they're killing the yellow wire. So we need 24 volts. And the white. Amp meter. Right there. See what kind of amps we run. Disconnect in. Fan starts up. Heat strips come on. all right. Let's complete cycle of the heat. Make sure the heat strips come on. I like to let the fan run until it turns itself off. That way I know it's going to cycle. And be sure the heat strips are not getting cooled off. I don't like having it on and then just kill the power and the heat strips are nice and hot. They don't have a chance to cool. The fan running cools them heat strips down and then shuts itself down and ready to go. So now put the panel back on, go to the next unit, check the heat on that. Looky, looky, when I open the door, guess what I find? Find a nice, as I was saying before the phone rang again, we find a nice little Brinkman little flashlight, which is probably, the batteries are probably dead sitting in here. But somebody left a nice little flashlight. Yeah, moisture and all up in there. So, probably, yep, we'll check that later. But, all right, now, let's see what we've got here. Variable speed on this. I do believe this is something like a 16 SEER unit. So, no capacitor there. But, you have to check every bolt and all, because sometimes you'd be surprised what you'll come across in a unit. A little corrosion down there, not much, just on a sequencer. Now, what I have found, let me show you what I found. Look into the compartment here. I see a little space here, you know, nothing really to be concerned about. This one's the same way. But when you look over here to this one, look there. I can take that one out by hand. I'll screw it down, tighten this bad boy up. So yeah, that was actually not attached at all, because when I grabbed hold of it, I can actually pull it up without turning it. So that needs to be tightened. I'm going to just snug them all down just to be sure. So let's get to that. now she's tied up in there. All right. That's a lot better. Check. Let's see what we're gonna have to do here to get this to jump out. We'll have to get some jumpers to jump this out. Like we got a possible three-stat in here. Possibly going to the coil. Nope, flip switch. I see. It just ran through the cabinet, came out down here. That's what. That goes to the flip switch. Okay. We'll have to jump out. Red and green. Let me see. There we go. There we go. Now I can see. We'll jump them out. And so we can fire up and see how many amps are pulling. This is a 10 kW heat. Here so we can read all the amps. Okay, let's get some power to this thing so we can test this out. Fan and all, we're pulling 40 amps. And the fan now is only pulling 1.2 amps. Somewhere. I'm always lined up perfectly every time. All right. Okay. Up, closed up. Now, move on to the third air handler. I like making videos of mine, that way I can make documentation. Yeah, I can see it burnt right there.
Yeah.
Huh. And all it is just touch that wire right there. Wow. Okay, so that means that should be enough slack in it. Of all the ones you actually watch on, you actually get to see something actually wrong. Yeah. Wow. All the other ones, nothing wrong. You pick, and you just happen to pick one. So I can get in there, small screwdriver. Boy, that's going to be fun getting in there. I don't know why they put that there that way. I didn't have a screwdriver that short. I don't know if I got one in my bag for that short. Never had a run that short to get one.
What size? Because I've got some.
It's just a regular filler. I mean, a flathead. I got some in the truck, but it's very rare I have to have a flathead or Phillips.
Yeah.
Oh, let's see if I got one or not. I mean, I've got another toolbox on the truck for the odds in there that I use, but Phillips.
We went to put our amp meter on the wire here to check the amps. And as soon as we did, we had a spark, as you can see right there. That wire right there was rubbing against that ground wire. That's exactly the reason why I say, like, the capillary tubes and the copper lines and all that in a unit, as well as the electrical wires, be sure they're not rubbing against each other, because when these units vibrate, they'll just wear against each other and eventually they'll short out, or the copper tubings, capillary tubes, whatever, will spring a leak. So let's hopefully we should be able to get enough wire out of here. Probably have to take that staple out right there to get enough wire to rewire this right here. First thing we want to do is be sure the voltage is off, even though the disconnect has been pulled. We'll be sure that it has. Don't think it hit long enough to that ground to actually short out and trip a breaker. But it's not reading anything on either one of the legs to ground. So it would be good. But we always take that extra caution, just it's a good measure to do so. So we're gonna put on some gloves. Let's get this actually come out of here. We got one come out. No problem. Get the other one. Really? Okay. Got the two wires out. Bad it is if we need to actually relocate and strip it or whatever it is. It's burnt pretty bad. Ground wire is about burning in half. We're gonna have to definitely give it more. We'll see how much we can get out of it. We'll have to get that wire staple out to be able to work with it. Get this out of here. First, get these ground wire out of here. Yep, the ground wire just came right off because it burnt so bad right there. Now, wire straightened out. Using this Romex connector, so we get this wire pulled in just a little bit more and cut the end off of it. We have enough wire to play with. Spacer there to keep it from being too loose. So put that back in.
there. Tighten that wire right back up in there. Yes. Come back right to here. Strip it right here. Don't want to slip that knife in there too far because it might skin a wire. It'll be right back in the same predicament that we are already in. Here we go. Off. Get off the ground. Now we get some wire cutters. You can see where it burnt. It kind of just cuttered it all the way back here. So we're going to cut all the way back to here. Make sure we got all the damp parts out of it. And it burnt right there. So we're going to come back the same. Same area there. Since they did mark that as a hot, we're going to do the same thing. So it'll be identified as a hot wire, not a neutral. Getting the wires, new wires back in. Tight little spot here, but not impossible to get to. That's in there. Nothing's touching anything else. Tighten up as much as we can by hand. Slug it up. Okay. Wires separated from each other. Nothing's touching anything else. All right. Let's see what we have in here. Hopefully you can see that. We got all these three wires separate. Got a good ground nicely in there. Nice and snug in there. They're not touching each other. So now we can actually put some amp meter on it and check the amps on the heat strips and all. Alright, time to put the disconnect in. We're all good over there. Ah, it didn't spark that time. That's good. All right, let's get the 24 volts and heat strips. Let's see here. Come on. There we go. got rolling here. This is variable speed as well. Don't know. Oh, didn't trip a breaker, so we're good.
¿19.6? ¿1.25? She's back together. All taped up here. There's a rubber seal that's supposed to be around these drains. That's not there like it is here. So we've got some tape. Put that tape back on there that was there. So now we go crank these bad boys up. Check defrost on 2 and check the charge on all 3. Which is going to take some time. Hopefully the battery don't die before then. Now we're going to check them pressure wise. They're all running. Quiet. Nice. Okay. So let's get to it. Check defrost.